And we're receiving content. We should be live any second now. And we are live. The internet can totally see me. What's up, guys? GB2017 here. And welcome to my stream today. Welcome one, welcome all. Daniel is here first. Welcome, sir. Thank you for joining me. Welcome, guys. I apologize for the wait. And I also apologize for the change in plans. The plan was to build Vault 101 from Fallout 3, the vault that you start out in, and build it from scratch and have a lot of fun doing it. But I went back and played through that segment in Fallout 3 just to get a sense of what the vault was like and to get some... I recorded some footage to kind of refer to. And I thought it'd be really fun to just stream it and kind of reference back and forth and kind of build it piece by piece. But I realized two things. Number one, there is not enough room here to build Vault 101. I don't think it would fit here, and I didn't want to run into any restrictions. That wouldn't have been a lot of fun. And number two, it is going to take forever to do like a really good job. So I don't know if you guys would be interested in seeing me try to build that like soon after I move or something like that, but we're just gonna play through the Vault-Tec DLC because number three, you guys might be thinking, well, why don't you just build Vault 101 elsewhere? That's definitely the idea. I'm gonna do that, but I haven't actually beat the quest yet, so I decided to just continue the stream. We're just going to play through the Vault-Tec quest. Yes, the Vault-Tec DLC is out. And that's what we're doing in this stream. So, just a chill stream today. And I hope you guys are excited. Welcome. Thanks for joining me. We are in Vault 88. And we're going to clear out... Vault 88 is surprisingly large. Surprisingly big. What do I think about building a vault base at Ten Pines Bluff? I don't know how big Ten Pines Bluff is. I think you might be disappointed with the amount of size. But then again, I'm not sure. I don't know. So that might be enough room. I'm not really sure. Let's see, what do I have on this character? Honestly, this is just a random character I threw on. I think this is a character I used to record a lot of videos with. I don't know if you guys remember from back in the day. The female soul survivor with the green combat armor. This has kind of been my standard. What's up, guys? Welcome, welcome, welcome. No survival mode today. That is the normal schedule, but we have DLC, so that's going on a hiatus. And I'm actually moving tomorrow. I'm moving down the hall into another apartment in the same building and same apartment complex and everything. Same floor. So it's going to be a really easy move, but... this is my last stream where I am, which is nice. You guys can't see it, but I have to, every single time I stream, I have to do a little setup, put up lights, obviously, the green screen behind me. I went and bought a nice L-shaped desk, and I'm gonna set that up, and I'll have my own office, so I won't be in a giant room. There won't be echo that you guys clearly hear right now. And also, I'll be able to pin my, I don't know if I'll pin it to the wall or not, but I'll be able to set up my green screen in a space that I don't have to move it. It's literally going to be so easy to stream slash do some kind of face cam related content, which is really nice. So, I'm excited. I am enjoying this DLC so far. There's obviously been a fair share of salt, but I think a lot of it is from people that already decided that they weren't going to like it. You know what I mean? There are valid reasons to not enjoy the DLC. Not everyone's completely full of BS, but Maze and Fire, first live stream. Awesome. Thank you for joining us. We're glad to have you. Will I be doing Skyrim remastered commentaries? I don't know. I will be making some sort of content on Skyrim remastered, but I'm not really sure. This is a nice combat rifle I have. Gets the job done. And we got plenty of ammo, which is really nice. Someone on my Twitter suggested that I do this stream on survival for the building, which is such a troll thing to say. Like, yeah, do a building stream on survival. Literally the only survival aspect of that would be, or the only effect that would be is me having to eat every like 15 minutes. So we are not building Vault 101. If you just joined the stream today, welcome. Change of plans. We're not building Vault 101. Because I didn't prepare, and I didn't know that Vault 88 wouldn't support how big it is, because I forgot how big it is. And I haven't beaten the DLC quest line to enable me to build elsewhere. So it's a combination of me being unprepared, and that's pretty much it. Mass Effect Andromeda will be awesome. 100%. I really can't wait for that. I absolutely want to cover that on my channel. I don't have any chocolate, unfortunately. I ran out of chocolate. I am a chocolate fiend. I love chocolate. Can I put on a nudity mod? No. Sorry. Am I going to play No Man's Sky? Yeah. Actually, the last No Man's Sky trailer called Survive came out today. And so I think I want to do kind of a little breakdown trailer series of sorts on my channel. We're less than 2 weeks away from it, so it's pretty solid. I think it's a good time to release some of those videos, maybe like once every 3 or 4 days. So we're a little bit into this quest, unfortunately. We're like 20 minutes in, just because that's how long I had the progress that I had made already. So we're not actually starting from the beginning, unfortunately. I played a little bit of Doom, but not enough. I really didn't play enough of it. I don't know what I was doing at the time Doom is out. Probably a combination of Battleborn and Overwatch. Oh shit, yeah, this is an awful area. Awful area. I stumbled across this when I was just literally running around. Let's get a nice critter in there. So many rad scorpions in that little section right there. Yeah, we're not building today. I was just unprepared and I don't have enough room to build in here. So that'll happen soon. Oh, maybe over the weekend. Let's not die on normal. Rad scorpion. I didn't even need to take two. I think I have medicine on or medic on this character. Yeah, I'm looking forward to No Man's Sky as well. A playthrough of that. I will be doing a Nuka World playthrough. I saw that comment. Absolutely. Just like I've done with all the DLCs. And technically this right here is a playthrough. After doing the questline. I hear creepy crawlies coming after me. I'm just gonna let them do their thing. Where do I think I'm gonna build Vault 101? Where do I wanna build Vault 101? Spectacle Island might be a really good idea. Like, it doesn't make any sense, but I need a large, large buildable space. So. Yeah. Kind of the plan. Do I stream often? Yeah, twice a week now is pretty much the schedule. That might increase because I'll be able to stream more easily. And, yeah. Okay, so the goal now is to build a power bike. I'm just going to build one out here. We don't have screws. Shoot. Are there any screws around here? Hmm. What would give me a screw? That won't give me a screw. A typewriter? Yeah. It will give me a screw. All right. Let's go ahead and place this power cycle down. All right. Connect to terminal and then select the experiment. Okay. Let's see if I have... Yeah, I do. All right. Let's go ahead and do this thing. I'm doing well. Thank you for asking. Thanks for joining. I am actually probably going to hop back on Destiny once that new content comes out. I'm a little disappointed that it's in the same area. I don't know much about it, but that just seems so lazy. Like, big time lazy. All right. Let's hop on. They're probably so busy working on Destiny 2 that they're like, oh, let's just repurpose the same stuff and charge money for it. So, oh, I shouldn't just be sitting on this. I have to use a terminal. Would I like a Fallout film? Yeah, a Fallout film would be pretty cool. This needs to be connected to power, right? Because the terminal's not powered up. That's the problem. All right. That's the problem. Let's just build a little generator. There we go. Now, power cycle experiment. Additional power production, sustained usage incentives, environmental enhancer, notes from Dr. Brown. It's already successful, wasteful exercise turned into clean power, but I task your R&D team to reach even further. How can we further refine the product? Are there opportunities to further other goals of Vault-Tec? Okay. Do I prefer ultra light or deep pockets? I prefer deep pockets, personally. I think one's better than the other. I just always take deep pockets. Do I have No Man's Sky pre-ordered? No, but I mean, I'm probably going to. Is there any incentive for pre-ordering that game on PC? Because I'll be getting it on PC. All right, let's do additional power production. Wait, let's check this out. By administering electric shocks when the subject's rotations per minute dip below acceptable levels, the amount of power generated can be increased. Voltage decreased by 50%. Okay. All right. Usage incentives. Let's see what this is. Over the many trials, we have found some test subjects would present physical resistance. Using coercive or psychological force to maintain could prove problematic. Discreetly injecting small dosages of buff out will have them pedaling longer and faster. Oh boy. After 43 hours of continuous pedaling, they suffered cardiac arrest. Wow. All right, that's an option. Let's check the notes on this one. Dr. Riley's team took a different direction despite the objections posited that associated with natural positive feedback. Strong aromatic essential oils, lavender and sweet orange. Strong initial impression, sub-audible soundtrack of gentle waves lapping on the beach. It was a failure. It doesn't work. All right, so that one doesn't work. Do we want to inject our guy with buff outs or shock them if they don't go over under a certain... I'm going to do the drugs. Let's do the drugs. All right. Clem, hop on, buddy.
I just want to trade a few things.
Oh, gross. I don't want that.
I'm just so excited to be here. I'll do good. You'll see.
All right, Clem. Do your thing. Do I have to... Okay. My opinion on Marvel Ultimate Alliance. I saw that and I was like, yeah, something that I can hop on with my friends. Am I, like, blocking him? He seems to be blocked. There. All right, Clem, do your thing. Hop on there, buddy. You got room. Yeah, he's hopping on. Marvel Ultimate Alliance.
This is all there is to it? So I'll keep pedaling.
I don't know about the graphics.
Kind of fun.
I think they're a little too dated. I really enjoyed playing back in the day. I don't think it justifies the $40 price. Way too expensive.
Oh boy. I'm feeling really good.
Ah, shit.
Best.
Keep going. I think Clem is just a little basic in the head.
Some people complain, not me. Just happy to be here.
I think that's the problem.
I'm so.
We have 329 people watching. Crazy. Welcome, guys. I didn't think we'd have so many today. Thanks for joining me. My favorite DLC so far is absolutely Fahaba. Big time. All right, so we're just letting him do his thing. This is a silly DLC. I really don't like that person just wandering around. Wish I could tell them to just go somewhere and stay.
There's a point to it, right?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure Clem has been hit on the head too many times. I don't know the true origin or reason I have this green combat armor. I think I put on a mod, and I had since uninstalled the mod, but not correctly, and so I'm just stuck with it. Yes, I'm going to play Mass Effect Andromeda big time. Do I think Nuka World will be better than Fahaba? I don't know. I think Far Harbor definitely, like, Far Harbor belongs, in my opinion, with the rest of the really memorable Fallout series of DLCs. So, my surprise with how my poll went yesterday on Twitter. Holy shit! I did not expect that whatsoever.
Hey,
Jesus.
There.
Oh man, I'm sorry. I broke your vault. I just got so excited I wanted to do a good job, and I kept pedaling faster and faster.
I don't know what the results were. Let me look at it.
Kablooey. Please
look at it on my phone.
Kick me out.
All right. Repair the power cycle. Yeah, we're not going to kick you out, Clem. We're just trying to torch you a little bit. Oh, sorry. Let's go into this. Repair. Yes. All right. Talk to the overseer.
I was looking at the data for the power cycle. The power output of the unit was, well, acceptable.
Is that test done already? I want to do more.
My, such enthusiasm. Perhaps I underestimated the advantages of applied narcotics.
Once I do your
applied narcotics
thing, can I
Mass Effect Andromeda wishlist? That's a good video idea.
For the next experiment.
Yeah, it's a good video idea.
We'll need something from outside. Vault-Tec subcontracted out chemical research to Hallucigen Incorporated. It was supposed to be delivered before. Well, before. But with the mail service.
Okay.
I'll be back before you know it.
Excellent. Once we have that.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so I gotta go grab a package with to leave the vault. Interesting. He's just hopping back on there. Alright, let's go,
hey.
Kate.
Sure, sure.
Come on.
Just keep your shirt on. These were the lucky
All right.
ones, eh? Doesn't look like
Let's go to Hallucigen. Get out of here. Yes, I am continuing the survival mode playthrough. Today we're taking a little break from that because of the DLC. Yes, I will be doing some pre-release No Man's Sky stuff. Let's see. No Man's Sky comes out August 9th. Today is the 27th, less than 2 weeks away. So expect probably 3 or so No Man's Sky videos before it comes out. I don't think I'll be an all-out destroyer. I think I'll be an explorer. I really want to explore. And trade. Yeah, I want to see what the best way to get a bunch of, you know, space credits is going to be, whatever the currency is. I don't even know. I need to do more research on the game. But I'm very excited for it.
What?
Am I going to be more involved in making the vault? What do you mean? Like focusing a little more? Hey-o. Probably. If you're referring to like building Vault 101, yeah, I'm going to actually spend my time on that. I've said before that I don't enjoy building that much, but I just ran through Vault 101 on Fallout 3 before I started the stream, And it is shocking the amount of... Whoops. Yeah, we might die here. Yeah. It is shocking the amount of similarities there are in all of the objects that are literally just better versions of objects that were already in the game. Like, maybe this shouldn't be shocking. Let's try and sneak out of here.
Whoa. You hear that?
Like, literally, I can make a bunch of really identical rooms. Like, it's going to be a very cool video eventually once I make it.
Let me know if you find
comparing, you know, the Fallout 4 Vault 101 to the Fallout 3 Vault 101. It's going to be really cool. So I'm really excited to make that video. Do I have anything to... Just kind of... Yeah, I'll just take a rat away. Sure, I have a rat away. Or, sorry, a rat X. There's a guy right there. My favorite Mass Effect race? It's got to be the Asari, right? Right? The all-female blue race? The blue people? The blue females? They're just really cool. Why don't I just fast travel? Well, I am in combat. So...
How much you got left in you?
That's a thing. I can't get up from here, can I? I'm using a mighty combat rifle. As you guys know, I can fast travel now. As you guys know, I love combat rifles. It's my favorite kind of weapon. Gosh, I love all these fast travel recommendations. Appreciate it. Well, there's the Reaper telling me I could have fast traveled from the inside. I was not aware. Do I know anything about the new Mass Effect game? The extent of what I know is that the main character will be named Ryder. And it will be human. BioWare holds the fact that Mass Effect is kind of... It's an experience of, you know, the main character being a human and then going out into the world and experiencing... The universe, you know, the planets and all that, and experiencing what it's like to be a human and encountering all those different races, which is cool. They've said that it's, you know, they're in the Andromeda system, right? They're not in the Milky Way anymore. So we should expect different new races, which is really exciting stuff. In terms of feel and how the game plays, it's going to be more like Mass Effect the original, so exploration is going to be a lot more of a focus, which is great. I can't tell you how amazing Mass Effect, the original Mass Effect, is. It's just incredible. I mean, you could just walk around that game, talk to NPCs, learn more about the world around you. It's just incredible.
A chemical leak has been detected.
Yes, there's going to be a new Mass Effect.
Evacuate the building immediately.
It smells strange.
Okay, please. Calm down. Yeah! Grim Reaper sprint. Remember how stupidly good that perk was in Fallout 3? Because I do. Yeah, Mass Effect is like semi-open world. I want to say that Andromeda is going to be the most open world, but I don't know. From what I've heard so far. Yes, the gunners do attack each other in here. I like this place. It's pretty cool. I'm really just here for the objective, though, so if you see me passing stuff, because I don't really need it.
Okay. Please, evacuate the building.
Alright, this is what I'm looking for in here. Is that? That's on the other side of the wall. Okay.
We should get out of here.
Oh.
What?
Yeah, you're damn right I'm gonna go through all the work of the killing. Of course. I'm on a normal game mode playthrough right here. This is easy mode. I could just sit here. Yeah, I'm gonna sit here for a second. A tutorial on how to build Vault 101. I don't know about a tutorial. I just think that would be hard to do, because it would take forever. Fallout or COD? Definitely Fallout. How would I die if I was on normal? Because I stepped out of a place and three people were shooting at me and I wasn't paying attention.
Yes.
Alright.
Who's there? Won't be able to pick this.
Alright. No, if I drop back down, that's exactly where I was before. I need to get around. Yeah, I remember this. That's a trap. Let these guys kill each other.
Please, evacuate the building.
Yeah, I want to stream the Vault 101 build. I just think it's going to take a really long time. Like, I think that's some interesting content, though. And, you know, I'd rather just hang out with you guys while I'm building, right? So, it's gonna take a long time. Thank you, Madara. That's very kind of you. Where are my eyebrows? I think they're on my face. I have taken a look. Sometimes I just spend a few hours in the mirror looking for them. They elude me, but sometimes I'm able to find them. There's sometimes on my face, like this area. There's Queen Pearl, and my girlfriend's here. Everyone say hi. I should dye my eyebrows. No thanks. No. I don't think so. Alright, let's grab this stuff. Head on out.
A chemical leak has been detected. Please evacuate.
I like how this the intercom voice guy is the same for every single place you go. Always the same guy. It's also the high school intercom announcement voice. Like, I'm going the right way, aren't I? I don't have any jokes. I'm sorry. I'm not somebody that just has a joke prepared whenever someone asks me to tell a joke. If power runs through the floor, has it reached the second floor? It also runs through walls.
Get out of my head. Get out. Get out.
It's just kind of how you connect everything. I'm not going the right way, I don't feel like. But I'm going to keep going.
Welcome to the Hallucigen Labs observation.
Yeah. Please step up to I'm familiar with the Hallucigen Labs area. Okay, now we're heading back down. Alright, what do we want to level up and grab? Let's see here. As you can tell, pretty much going for the best combat build. I just say that because I want to trigger some people. I want somebody to tell me I'm wrong. Mysterious Stranger. Action points. Ninja. So I don't have luck 10. Let's go into Action Girl. Yeah, no eyebrows. You betcha. I don't need eyebrows. I'll take your bottle caps, sirs.
Have to
Is there a key card around here? I would be grabbing those bottles if we were on survival. There is a minigun down here. I wasn't aware of that. How do I get in here, guys? I don't remember. There is another outside door to get what I need.
Please evacuate the building.
Novice terminal in the room I was just in. Okay. Thanks, guys. Appreciate it. Right here. Yeah, that's it. Okay. Let's see. Any duds I can get rid of? No. Right there, right there. There. Plenty of duds. Okay. Grows. Mainframe, we don't need that. Master password reset, got it. Beautiful.
A chemical leak has been detected. Please.
Someone's getting punched really hard. Why is my screen shaking? It's weird. Was I made in a cold laboratory? Yes. Father was by my side the whole time, holding my synth hands. Yeah, the jig is up. My girlfriend has outed me. As a synth. Just a dirty synth. Okay. Let's go ahead and use this right here. Oh, sorry guys, hold on. I got someone who wants attention. This is the only attention they'll get. There you go. All right.
Has been detected. Please evacuate the building immediately.
Alright. So, dude, I'm here. Avoiding this trap like a ninja. Where'd he go? You what? I'm not getting attacked. Other people are fighting each other. That's what's happening. I kind of like that it set me out here, honestly. Like, I've been here before, but I didn't realize that. Thank you for the bed suggestions, but we're not on survival. This isn't my survival character. We're doing a, we're doing just a playthrough of the Vault 88 quest. Oh, he put on a stealth boy? Okay. Alright, let's go ahead and fast travel back and get back to it. Vote me for president. I think I'm a pretty good president. I'm not, like, super bigoted. Not really bigoted at all. So I got that for me, which is great. I'm also not being investigated for certain crimes that I may or may not have committed. How long have I been streaming, James? I've been streaming for 34 minutes today. So, if you want to catch the first 34 minutes, this will be streamed. This will be uploaded after the stream ends today. Yeah. Hey, I'd have a decent amount of people vote for me. That's all I need to know. Synth for president. Yeah, you guys... What if I was in the race, right? What if it was synth versus Hillary versus Trump? Third party synth vote? I think I could swing that, right? I'm not sure how long I'll be streaming today.
I'll do well. Promise.
I don't know. At least 2 hours. I might go longer though, because I want to finish this.
Now we can reform another societal Piccadilly. The hydration break.
Oh.
Whether it rears its head around the coffee pot, water cooler, or soda fountain, it's a menace. Vault-Tec scientists have conducted experiment after experiment to eliminate this inefficiency, but people feel an irrational need to socialize. So if they must squander their time, let us turn it into the collective good with chemistry.
What? Aren't chemicals bad
for
you?
Shut the fuck up, Clem!
Oh, Clem, you worry so much, my boy. Everything you eat and drink is made of chemicals, don't you know?
Oh, right. That's very interesting, Lady Overseer.
These are just special chemicals.
The eyebrows, they're up here, man. My policies, I'll tell you of my policies. I'll think of them. I'm just going to get through this dialogue.
Let's get started.
So build the soda fountain. And then serve refreshments to our residents. And Clem, if you get thirsty on the job, feel free to have a cool, refreshing beverage.
Gee, thanks.
The soda fountain shows enormous potential.
Okay. Build a soda fountain. Let's do it. So my policies would be, obviously, since our people. I know it's crazy. But that would be a policy under my platform. So synths would have rights, which is pretty crazy, I know. Let's see, what else would I do? I mean, I am a synth. I can't just betray my kind, right? Couldn't do that. So, what else? What else would be my policies? I think the synths would be pretty liberal for the most part. Synth lives matter. Pretty much. That's all I got. Alright. Clem, you gonna do your thing? Do you not? Oh, wait, I need to choose a parameter. Keep forgetting. Alright. Soda fountain experiment. Appetite suppressant. Let's see what the notes are for this. We've achieved remarkable progress in synthesizing a lipstatin derivative. Lipstatin. True, the side effects are more pronounced, but the efficiency is remarkable. Test subjects over the trial period have lost 10% body mass index. Wow. There have been unfortunate loss of productivity among the subjects, one complete loss from a fatality, and two refuse to get out of bed. But the others are consuming a quarter or less of standard ration. Okay. So, we just need less food to feed the vault. Okay. Appetite suppressant, so they eat less. Mood enhancer. Ooh. Hallucinogen has provided us with a small sample of the final product. Quite exciting. They've made an extremely psychoactive compound that's soluble in water. Creates short-term euphoria and in some cases mild hallucinations. Surprisingly, subjects suffered no withdrawal symptoms, though a substantial predilection to depression after the crash. In a first for our team, absolutely no fatalities. The worst side effect is subject 13, who has been staring at his hand for 13 hours straight. Fascinating. All right. This is good. Okay, that's interesting. That sounds like some We Happy Few stuff right there, that drug right there. All right. Generic caffeination. I'm just about to give up on Ted. If you parse out his team's elaborate presentation, the active ingredient of supplement Z is just caffeine, plain ordinary caffeine. Surprisingly, suffered no deleterious side effects. Teams spent an inordinate amount of time balancing flavor and carbonation. Okay. So I think it tends to be the bottom one doesn't work. After the initial stockpile of food and drink are depleted, we'll become accustomed to anything we give them. Adding chemical supplements to their diet. Soda fountain. Okay, that's fine. All right, what do we think, guys? I think I want to go with the drugs. I like seeing Clem enjoy himself. Let's do that. Mood enhancer.
I guess I'm open for business.
All right, you're open for business, Clem. Let's go.
Have a minute? Got something on my mind.
Oh, God. Oh, we're going to awkwardly walk away from the situation. Sorry. Sorry, Kate. I need to observe Clem. I need to take notes.
The soda fountain's open. Want to be the first customer?
Depends. How much does it cost?
Oh, it's free.
Really? Well, I guess then.
All right. Prepare to have your mood enhanced.
Oh, it tastes... it tastes funny.
All the soda you can drink. Make sure to come back.
Oh, that's cool. I got that little water effect at the top. Oh, no, that's the soda. Oh, yeah. Cool. All right. What are my building plans for Vault 88? Right here in this stream, I'm really just building the bare minimum. I might make a really cool vault. I have a hard time building in this game.
Maybe I'll get another drink.
But if I have an exact goal in mind, like Vault 101, then I can build. Definitely. Yes, I'm excited for Nuka World. A little bit excited for Skyrim Remastered.
It ain't
Nuka. I mean, it's an experience. It's an experience that I've already had. Although I don't think I played enough of Skyrim compared to Fallout. Simply just because I like Fallout more than Skyrim. But I'm definitely going to pick it up and play it. No doubt. And I think mods are an exciting prospect as well. I've never modded Skyrim. So. Okay, Queen Perla is abandoning me to watch a lit show. That's fine. That's fine.
Nuka-Cola, but
I understand. I will get Battlefield 1, yes, definitely. Absolutely. Watching me while drawing your own vault. That's a good job, Stan. I'm not a good job, a good plan.
Yes.
Absolutely. Yes, I'm really excited for No Man's Sky. I am excited to get lost in that game.
All the soda
for sure. I really did roofie Clem, didn't I? I could just wait, couldn't I? I think we're almost done. I'll wait next time. I do kind of want to, like, see what, you know, comes of these experiments. Fallout 3, New Vegas, or Fallout 4? I think after the recent conversations I've shared with you guys through the criticism video of Fallout 4 and through learning about shandification, I definitely want to say Fallout New Vegas. I've spent the most time with Fallout New Vegas. Actually, maybe not. Probably Fallout 4 at this point.
Maybe I'll get another drink.
But I don't know. I have the fondest memories of New Vegas.
You here to check
out? I think that's for
a
good reason.
Right here. You're back!
Oh, yeah, this vault's amazing. Just great. Wow.
Yeah, just great. It's so great, I don't even know what I'm saying.
Neither do I.
Lol. Overseer's probably not going to like this one. Probably not.
Excuse
a playthrough
me.
Of Doom.
Think we've turned the
simple I think I'm kind of past Doom.
Into something noble. It fills me with pride. On to the next prototype. The Hippocratic Oath. A solemn vow to do no harm. Well, roughly, that's what it means. I don't want to get into interpreting dusty Latin textbooks. But that...
Yeah, they're probably both high.
The medical community runs counter to what we're trying to accomplish here. Doctors shouldn't put their patients' welfare first. Instead... their sole focus should be the collective good. You understand? Of
collective
course.
Good. What is that, collective good? Is that utilitarianism?
Let's stop with the philosophy 101 and get to the job.
I think that's what that
of
is, right?
Course. So,
enter the vault. As of now, No Man's Sky doesn't look like it's coming out for Xbox One. Doesn't mean it won't in the future, but equipment that,
yes, can improve a patient's eyesight, but potentially so much more. The prototype requires a bit, well, a lot. All right, a staggering quantity of radioactive material. But the results will be worth it.
Okay.
Nuclear material, you say?
What could go wrong?
It's foolproof. We chose this site for Vault 8.
Rich source of uranium. All right. Let's go for it. Just dive on in. My birthday is October 17th, guys. I'm 21 years of age. Let's see. Okay, whatever. We'll just head towards it. Alright, that's the direction of... Alright, so there. So they have what I need to build. They're just assuming I don't have the... Well, I almost have the nuclear material. For the Foropter. Foropter. I wasn't paying attention to how she said that. That's fine. Alright. Yeah, October 17th is a great birthday.
Ammo, caps, whatever you find, don't...
Let's go ahead and throw on... Red X. It's in pretty much my favorite time of the year. Although in Texas, it's been really hot. Still in October, and it sucks. Wait, so is this supposed to be the location of the... Oh, that's why. Hey, hi, hello. Wait, I took Radix, right? And I'm still getting that much radiation. Interesting. Alright. No... Grab the tail. Torso. Torso. The sun will explode before PS4 mods come. Yeah, right. I love the comments where people are like, you know what? Honestly, they're probably not coming out at all. Those are hilarious. Like, you know, somehow you came to that logical conclusion that, you know, who knows, man, probably just not coming out at all. Pokemon Go or nah? Oh, absolutely Pokemon Go. 100%. Is No Man's Sky going to tell your home world location? No. I don't think so. I don't believe so. Alright, what's up with the marker? Or is there just uranium I can... Oh, I can scrap it, right? That's what it is. Okay, I already have what I need. Yeah, I just realized that. Thank you. Let me, go ahead and rat away. Rat away, rat away. And... I don't know what I just did there. oh yeah, Team Mystic for sure. 100%. Will I make Skyrim remastered videos? I don't know how many videos I will make. With manufacturing extended, you can make Vault 101 jumpsuits. You can populate your Vault 101. That's a good idea, Blue Skull. That's pretty cool, actually. Excited for Pokemon Go, too. Yeah, dude. So excited. So hyped. Alright. Improve settlers' eyesight. Just stick this over here and make another generator. Big time. So hyped for that game. Pokemon Go, too. Alright, Clem. Oh, yeah. I gotta... Shit.
Yummy soda.
Nice, Clem. That's not what I meant to do. I meant to just store it. right there. We don't have enough power, do we? No, we do not. Let's scrap that. I'm really efficient, guys. Don't worry about it. I know I am. Shit, I just wasted screws. Okay. I should have just stored that generator. I have 13 small generators. I am not being efficient here. However, that does not matter, because I can keep doing this. All right. Why does my sound like, why does my voice sound like everything good in the world? I don't know. That's very nice of you. All right, notes. The challenge I put before you is to find a way to turn a simple eye exam to something that furthers our ambitions. The Foropter is an excellent delivery mechanism, infrequent enough and arcane enough that if anything irregular occurs, no one would know. What? All right, subliminal messages. Let's see what's going on here. Design a series of microflash images, which when played in repeatedly and in a loop, statistically significant positive effect on subjects. Oh, okay. We never quite perfected an eyedrop formula that was both effective and had long-lasting trauma, so they're still working on that. Okay. So we do subliminal messages for our test subjects. Fault monitoring. Team Walrus. small MRI specifically designed to fit in the Foropter. When fed enough power, imaging can process visual information in response from stimuli. In layman's terms, it can read a test subject's mind and show an actual picture of what they're thinking about. Images are very grainy and indistinct, starting from standard Rorschach tests, hundreds of volunteers, 71% accuracy, still early days, involuntary glimpses. Okay, game changer for vault management. Or improved eye care. This is probably the BS one. Simple synopsis of this experiment, Ted. His team made a better tool for optometrists everywhere. That's it, nothing else. Okay, so that's the one that's not. Okay, so subliminal messaging or vault monitoring. Reading minds or... Let's do subliminal messages. Yeah. All right.
Looks like we have our first...
I have heard of Dead Rising 4. I don't know how I feel about Dead Rising.
Before we begin,
honestly.
How do you feel about children?
They're all right, I guess.
You ever play
Oh, God.
I don't know. Why are you asking?
Just idle chatter. Go on.
Hi. You
hear no one likes Ted.
This thing?
I guess.
Go ahead and get it.
All right. Subliminal messages. Let's go right here. Let's brainwash our vault dwellers.
So, what do I do?
Favorite Fallout 4 DLC is absolutely Fahaba. I have heard of We Happy Few. I need to download it, actually.
This thing's not working!
What were you doing?
I kept saying obey the overseer.
Well, that's just a quirk of the prototype. Nothing to concern yourself with.
Bullshit. This ain't the end.
Okay.
What the hell is your game? You invite Clem and me in here to experiment on us?
Yep.
You some sort of sicko?
There's nothing sinister going on. You're just imagining.
I don't buy it, pal. Any of it. At least up in the Commonwealth, everyone's up front about trying to kill you or rip you off.
All right, I'm just gonna...
Come on, Clem. Let's leave. These guys are
assholes.
Shoot her.
But I can't. The power cycle. Gotta pedal some more when I'm done here.
Run while you can, Clem.
All right.
Anybody need help with anything?
Well, damn, she noticed. Is that, like, inevitable right there? I feel like it should be.
Hey there.
So, one of our residents left. Well, it'll be easy enough to replace her. The important thing is that our work...
Yes, our work is progressing.
What's the next job?
This last experiment is my pride and joy. Following in the footsteps of Dr. Braun and the others, I have spent my time devising my very own prototype. Its premise is this.
Oh, you can trick her, okay.
We are all flawed creatures, each with our own vices. What if our vault didn't pointlessly try to stamp out these predilections and instead harnessed them?
Give me the details.
The vice in question is greed. The schematic is for a slot machine. I designed it to be as enticing
I've seen this
as
one.
Possible.
Best vault you've ever
Choose
seen, I know, Fusion.
Experimental parameters.
It's very robust.
And let's see how it fares in the field.
Okay. Time for Clem to operate the slot machine. Or was I not paying attention? Yeah, no. Screws. I need screws. Screw this. I don't get any screws from that. I don't get any screws from that. Okay. I think we need to go out and, scrap some stuff. Get some screws. I won't need these. I'm bound to find some screws down here somewhere. So, if you just joined, welcome. We're about an hour into this stream today. And we are conducting vault experiments, doing the Vault 88 questline, which is just the DLC, essentially. No screws, really? Well, okay. Just give me the toilet. Is this gonna give me? No, it's not. See, that's just steel and rubber, because I know what that stuff's gonna give me. There's one screw. The quest for screws is on, guys. I could use console commands, but eh. I know we're gonna find screws down here. Right? Hopefully. Saw, dude. Welcome. Shoot the overseer. No. Oh. Get that out of the way. Still one screw short. Yeah, I could just scrap a weapon. That's a good point. Very good point. Let's do that. How about this combat rifle? Well then. What kind of weapon would have screws, guys? Yeah, a desk fan will have screws. I know that. I am going to build a proper vault, and it will be Vault 101, and it can't be down here because that's too big. Way too big. Security office? That's a great point. I know exactly what you're talking about. All right, let's run all the way back up there. I need a scrapper. That's right. Yeah, that would have given me screws, I think. Yeah, Kate's inventory could have that, for sure. Yes, we are on PC. I don't know if I told it Kate to, to hold anything. No, she only has a baseball bat. Do I have the Vault 101 schematics? Yeah, I do. On Reddit, someone made them, which is great. They did a great service for our country. Is that thunder? I think I hear thunder outside. Alright. security office over here. What's my deepest fear? I really don't like open water. Really not a big fan of deep, deep ocean water. It's just too much stuff underneath me. Too much room, too much potential for something. Yes! That's exactly what I needed. I don't know. That is definitely one of my... one of my worst fears. Not a big fan. Welcome, welcome, guys, to the stream. If you just joined, we're halfway through today. Potentially longer. We've almost got 500 of you watching. It's crazy. Thanks for joining me today, guys. All right, let's go ahead and out. There. How to power your vault with no wires. Well, you have to use the floor. On my video today, you just have to make sure that things are connected, and then if you have something you need to power that doesn't need a wire, like something you can put on the wall, for example, then you can do that. But like, you don't need to string wires directly from your generator at all. You just have to make sure things are connected through the floor, then use the new power conduit, and then if something needs a small wire, you can place a power conduit on the wall right there and then just wire that to the object. It's really, really easy, actually. How many hours have I played? I want to say between 500 and 1,000, perhaps 1,000 plus. But it's spread across two systems and not exact. And also, I do certain things, like, I definitely don't stay on the same character, so I can't just look and just count up, like, oh, that's how many hours I have. I switch around characters a bunch, I delete saves a bunch, so. Alright. So, gambling is alluring by its very nature. Casinos, big question. Device could manipulate probability, first to entice a subject, to later drain them of all their financial resources. Maximum revenue for the vault. All right. Indentured servitude. Wait, are there not... is this a bug? Or is... is it supposed to show... more details? Kind of weird. Mass Effect or Dragon Age? Definitely Mass Effect. I love both. It's kind of like Elder Scrolls versus Fallout. They're all in bronze notes. Or Barstow's notes. Okay. Okay. Do customer profiling. Let Clem gamble for an hour. Let's do it. New Vegas or four? I think a mix of nostalgia and other small things make me want to pick New Vegas. Kate, why are you in the way?
Sure.
No.
Over here.
Get the hell off of the gambling machine and stay.
Wait there.
Leaving me behind. It's your funeral.
Is a DLC worth $5? That's a hard question to answer, because it depends on what you want out of a DLC. If you are very resistant to workshop and you don't like to build, then it's probably not worth your $5. It is inherently worth $5, because you get actual items out of it. You're not getting ripped off. It's absolutely worth $5 as an add-on to a $60 game, but maybe not to you. And I'm pretty much going to explain that again. How would I recommend lighting up an atrium? I think the Bethesda stream of this DLC before it came out had a pretty good example. So you might want to hunt down that stream. I know I've linked it in a few of my videos. I think it's just a lot of those fluorescent lights, and then as long as you use the power correctly, then they'll be lit up.
My luck's gonna turn around.
All right. Don't use charisma on Clem or the overseer won't like you. Interesting. Lock your dwellers in a room with nothing but PS4 and COD ghosts. You what? Would I pierce my ears? No. I don't know. Something about... I'm going to say this, and it might offend some people, but... Something about piercing my ears would make me feel emasculine. Personally, me. Not saying it's... That's not a blanket statement for all people that pierce their ears. What?
It keeps making these weird clicking noises.
Clem, that's how it works. Trigger, did I just trigger you? It's funny. I'm planning to build a Vault 101 rebuild. A Fallout 4 version, fully decked out of Fallout 3's first vault. I think it's a really cool idea. I think it'd be really cool to share. You guys all triggered? Is there just a mass triggering of the entire
stream? Time to check in with the slot machine.
Hello from the Netherlands. Can't welcome. Wait. It's really late over there, isn't it? Not too late.
Hi.
Let's check in with...
Yeah, let's check in.
Hi. Is the slot machine supposed to flash?
Yep.
Every now and again, I swear it makes strange noise and flashes.
You must be imagining things. A slot machine doesn't take pictures of people.
Now we just need a variety act and some crime bosses and our casino's set.
Ah, your famous wit.
Very witty.
It's done. Finally. Hundreds of years.
Hello, in Australia. Planning. It's definitely the opposite time of day over there.
Vault-Tec would be so proud.
I did everything you asked. Can I go back to the power cycle? I really need to.
My, what gusto. I'm glad you like the cycle so much, Clem.
Poor Clem.
With my life's work done.
Is this it? We'll
deliver our schematics to other.
Did we complete it?
To improve their lives.
The vaults I know about have all failed.
The world's a big place. And I pass the mantle on to you.
Yes.
Guide Vault 88.
And I'm now overseer. Greatness.
You're the overseer now.
Yes. Reduces damage from ghouls. Oh, well, thanks. That's it. Wow. I don't know. I mean, I guess I should have expected a lot more than that, right? Well, that's it. I'm definitely not going to cut off the stream. Maybe we could do a little bit of vault building. Yeah, that's definitely thunder. Definitely thundering outside. I've got like soundproofing, not really soundproofing, but like blackout curtains that are pretty thick to also absorb sound while I'm streaming and, you know, reduce echo. And so I can't look outside, but I can tell you that it's storming. Actually, I'm just checking the weather real quick. Yeah, it's storming, but apparently it's supposed to stop. All right, so. Why do you want me to kill her? She's done. She's over with. I guess she's going to spread the rest of her vault evilness to the world. I don't know. People are funny. All right. So you can't exactly build Vault 101 from here. Now I can go and build wherever. So I could just leave this place, or I could stay. What do you guys think? You guys think I should... Actually, I kind of want to build here. Sorry. You thought I was giving you an option. I'm going to build a vault here, okay? Let's do that. Okay, so let's build a few more hallway pieces. But right here, let's open to a big, giant atrium. First, we have to put a doorway here. The thing's broke. It keeps making these weird... Like so. I'm liking what we're doing here. Alright. So let's open to a giant, big ol' atrium. Right here. Let's see. Okay, so that's an end piece. I don't want that. Be nice if this would clip on top of there. So I think I have to use the floor to make sure I'm on track. Wait, what? Wait. It's weird. Okay, hold on. Is that causing issues? Doorway both sides. Okay, thanks, guys. I literally just made a video on this. I forgot to put the doorway on the other side. The thing's broke. Tells you how forgetful I am. Alright. So I have to put the end cap, the door, and then I have to put the atrium door piece, the opening, on the other side. Okay. Okay. Alright, so let's do this. Let's go from here.
Did the machine just say degenerate?
Yes, it did. It sure did. Alright. Let's make this thing giant. I want to make a big atrium opening entrance. So, let's put the prefab end over here. Oh, wait. It's part of the floor. So, I have to do it this way. This is what I wanted. That's what I want. Just move this over here for now.
Did the machine just say degenerate?
All right, that's getting a little old. Okay. Making this thing, it's gonna be huge. All right. Way up here. Beautiful. Beautiful! And then the walls should snap, right? Hopefully. Let's see. I'm going the wrong way for walls, aren't I? That's a wall. I just want to make sure I wasn't missing anything. All right. Let's... So that's not going to snap on there, is it? Okay, so I have to cap these off. I'll make some rooms up here, actually. Corner bottom. Okay, so that'll go there. And then I need... That's what I need. Corner mid. Beautiful. Can you get bigger rooms? Well, I mean, you're pretty much given the tools to go crazy on your rooms. I mean, you can pretty much go absolutely insane. Is this gonna... I might just have to corner it off right here. That's gonna conflict. No, it's not. That's actually perfect. Exactly what I want. Okay. Let's build a... Oh, no, no. I need a corner bottom. God, it takes forever to scroll through this shit. How do you guys build so much with this stuff? There we go. And then wall bottom. I'm telling you guys, it's gonna be huge. Is there a roof piece? Or did I need to build the corner with a roof piece? Oh, I think I did. Yeah. Great. Alright. Okay. So corner with a top. There we go. This really is like, it's like fitting together a puzzle piece. Puzzle pieces. There we go. There needs to be a better way to navigate the menu. You're absolutely 100% correct. Totally on board with you on that. The thing's broke. It keeps making hanging floor atrium. So, let's see. So that, this is a prefab. That's why that has that right there. Ceiling floor. That's what I need. Yeah. So this is going to be like a second floor area. Okay. So, this is what we have right now. I kind of just want to make a big atrium, honestly. So, someone said on my video, there's a way to build a wall up and then make some roof pieces in the middle. That way, I don't have to just end my atrium and it doesn't have to slope back down. Well, I mean, I technically built the atrium sideways, that is true, but I mean, does that matter? I could literally just have this same path go through there and lead to another atrium. You can also just string atriums together. That's something I pointed out in my video. Let's just scrap this. Yeah, all that shit, all of it. I want none of you.
Did the machine just say degenerate?
Whoops, wrong button. I want none of this. We scrap all of it. Try to pick up this stuff. Alright. COD videos? I tried that a long time ago. Well, that was like my... Either my third or fourth most successful game has been Call of Duty. It has been a long time. I don't want these books. I really wish I could just scrap them. You're never supposed to throw away books. I've thrown away books. I've done it. Alright. So I just wanted that crap out of the way. I'm actually going to get rid of this stuff, too. Why can't you store that stuff? Seems kind of silly. But I'm actually just going to scrap all of it. Poor Clem. Can't gamble anymore. It's probably for his own good. Yeah. The Ray Gun and Thunder Gun troll videos. I did those. What are my plans in terms of content after Fallout is done? Well, Fallout will always be something that I post on the channel for the foreseeable future. I'll always be returning to it. So I don't see myself quitting Fallout cold turkey on the channel. But pretty much the time frame right now is... A month after Nuka World has been out is when things are going to start diversifying even more. So, at that point, you know, things will be changing. And Fallout will take more of a backseat to other kinds of content as the primary feature of the channel. It's definitely something that a lot of people are going to have to either adjust to or decide to move on from the channel. So this is what I'm talking about keeping this giant open atrium. I think it actually looks pretty cool. But I want to make sure and run... Let's put a bunch of flooring down, actually. What DLC should you get? If you have one choice, you definitely go Far Harbor. Definitely. Will I do Skyrim? Yeah, I'll put some kind of Skyrim content up, but it won't be a focus here on the channel. Definitely expect a video from me on it. At least one. That's all I can promise right now. I don't want to make any promises. Did I cheat for the materials? No. I mean, I can right now. I can easily just throw on... what do you call it? God mode and have 999 of everything. These are the materials that the game gives you. Like, you get plenty to start out with in this vault. Structural support for the roof. Would you like that? I mean, is it not enough structural support that it's all connected? I'm not an engineering major or anything, but... Seems like it'd be okay. Number one game if Fallout doesn't count. It would be the original Mass Effect, probably. Probably. I hate to go down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I like to give a collection of the top 10 and just... Because, I don't know, things... I change my mind on a daily basis about a lot of things, so... I think I've kind of come to the conclusion after doing a little more research, kind of understanding more about my experience with Fallout 3 and New Vegas, that New Vegas comes out a little bit more on top, though. Hey, Micah. Thanks for joining us. I'm doing well. Thank you for asking. Okay. Well, that's enough flooring for now. Of course, we're going to get back to it because there's so much we have to lay down. Okay. So we put that one there, and then, actually, I think I have to store that one because I need another end cap. Like so. No, it has to be back a little bit. Wait, how did I do that one? I put that back here, didn't I? Hold up. Didn't I? No, I didn't. I made that myself. I just put a regular ceiling piece. Like so. And then I had it extend backwards a little bit. Okay. So how many wide did I make that one over there? Definitely got to be symmetrical. So from the center, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4... And the fifth piece was the end. So, put that like so. There we go. Like so. All right. And then extends back one. For whatever reason I did that. I don't know, beats me. Let's just fill this all the way. This will be a huge open area. Plenty of room for activities. It might be a giant one-room vault. I mean, I'm taking up plenty of size already. Actually, is that size taking into account like a bunch of other stuff in this buildable area? So I feel like it probably does. Oh my gosh. Definitely not the first person to be frustrated by the way stuff snaps. Most anticipated game of this year. Right now, it's definitely No Man's Sky, but on my list, on my radar, there's Mafia 3, there's the Skyrim remaster, there's South Park, definitely, coming in December. It's pretty much the only big game coming in December, from, in my opinion, for me, that I absolutely plan on getting, obviously. But what about you guys? What else are you looking forward to? Let's go ahead and build that corner. Come on. Thank you. A mid-corner piece. Or actually, it needs to be a mid-corner, a corner piece with a top. That's what I want. And then I want just wall pieces with tops. I don't know. When you figure out how this stuff fits together, it's not that bad. And then let's just do a middle wall right here. Right? No. There we go. Okay, so that has... Okay, I put the ceiling floor there. Okay, so let's do that on the other side. Leave space for a generator room. I feel like almost putting the generator in here, just having a big one-room vault, and then... I mean, I can make rooms within this atrium. It's kind of what I'm planning on doing already. All right, I need the ceiling floor. I could put columns, too, to actually support the ridiculous atrium ceilings I have going on in this place. Yeah, I'm sure I will do that. Yeah, Mass Effect is going to be huge, but that's right now it's slated for spring 2017, but I don't know about that, honestly. I don't know how I feel about that timetable. I feel like that's not realistic, personally. I mean, I don't want it to get delayed, but I hope they're spot on. I think the last thing I heard was that they were, from E3, is that they're like in the home stretch of the game, which is fantastic. Like, that's really exciting. My opinions on Nuka World, I hope it's really good, honestly. I have nothing bad to say about it because I don't know any more than you guys do at this moment in time. So I think it needs to be, I don't know, the general community opinion right now of Bethesda is bad. It's negative. And so I think Nuka World needs to be a memorable Fallout experience. I think that's literally the only requirement for Bethesda. That's the only thing that I look for. If it is some kind of experience that I will remember that sticks out from the main game. Obviously, these workshop DLCs do not. So that's one of the immediate reasons why I'm not the biggest fan of these. So I want some memorable characters, a la Dima, who is pretty great. Nick Valentine in general also is just a fantastic character, in my opinion. I'm a big fan of Nick. Okay, let's put that up here. Just fit in there just like that, please. Wait, does that fit correctly? What? Why did that snap like that? Oh god. Oh, it's just so big and awkward. Nope, not quite. There we go. Haha. Okay. So that could lead to another portion. So we've got our entrance here. I will play the BioShock collection. Yeah, definitely. Absolutely. Looking pretty good. The reason I didn't put a end cap on there is because this rubble actually is really in the way. Kind of fucks up what I was trying to do. Huh. Kind of does on this side too. I can't do that right there because of this rock. It's really gonna trigger me right there, guys. And this is why You gotta know, you gotta have a plan, right? Before you start building. It's okay. Oh, I will rectify this somehow. Wait, are these ends better? Yeah, those ends are better. Make a little more sense. Come on. Does that clash with something? Is that not gonna work? Eh, well. Guess that's not better. Put that back up there. Huh. Also, it would have to extend further out this way in order for me to actually end it. Well, shit. This is definitely not what I planned for. Oh, well. Let's go ahead and place some kind of power source. I'm going to put it right in the middle here. Okay. Put a big ol' Vault-Tec reactor. All right, we need to go back for nuclear material. To the tunnels! Where would I like the next Fallout to be? So I made that video, but I'll pretty much reiterate with what I said in the video. I would like Bethesda, because I do truly... I don't know. There's, like, I know Mr. Maddie made a video on the possibility of Obsidian being bought by Bethesda. I don't know if that's going to happen. If that happens, it truly does change what I think will happen next, because if that happens, I do think that Obsidian will make the next Fallout game, just because I know Bethesda is just a far way off before they make another Fallout game. But if Bethesda makes the next Fallout game, I think they'll return to California. I just think that makes the most sense. They haven't made a game in California, a Fallout game, because they've stuck in the Northeast. So, California, probably a good idea. Makes sense to me. Shit. Oh my god, gross. Is this where the uranium was? I think I went the wrong way. Logan. I only cuss when I feel like it. I don't want to make this completely just a stream full of... Oh my god! Goodness gracious. I don't think I went the wrong way. Minnesota. That's a really interesting place. I don't know anything about Minnesota. Except for that it's a place with people in it. I would like to see some snow, too. I think snow would be a great backdrop for a Fallout game. A lot of people are like, Fallout Russia. I don't think it's a good idea to take Fallout out of the U.S. It's just such a big part of the identity of the game and the feel of it. It would just be completely different. Like, I wouldn't be, like, ultra opposed to it. It's just that it would fundamentally change the feeling of the game. You'd get a more... Shit. You'd get a more, Metro feel. I would, at least. Alright, what do we want here? Obviously, right? Obviously. Yeah, San Francisco would be really cool. Oh, well, shit. I don't want to die. Huh? Oh shit. I was gonna save. I'm gonna save right now. Just in case things go wrong. With these goddamn bastards. Let's throw a plasma grenade. They go up there. I'm gonna blow myself up, aren't I? Yeah, Fallout 4 is not gonna do another DLC. I don't believe there's gonna be another DLC, but if they did, yeah, it would need to be some other cool place. So, dude. Suck it. I did not do enough damage. I strongly disagree with that damage. All right. Yeah, I do think that Fallout 4 should have another DLC, but it's not going to. Unless PR does something that PR normally doesn't, which is tell people something and then guarantee something and then change their mind. I don't know. I just don't see it. All right. I don't know how much material I needed because I wasn't paying attention. But I should just grab as much as I can, right? That's a good idea. I think that's all I need, actually. Let me check. Let's go over to junk. Switch to component view. Wait. No, because I'm not holding it. I scrapped it. That's why. Okay. Some glowing over here, but no uranium material. How do you explain that? You don't. Debris, gotta get rid of this. I'm getting some major lag here. The stream is fine. That was just really bad stuttering lag. Where's the cowboy hat? Unfortunately, not on my head. Did not break out the cow. I don't think I have the cowboy hat over here. I think it's at one of my parents' houses from when I lived home, at home. Honestly, I think I'm good, right? Can I access the workshop from here? Yeah, I can. I totally can. So, let's see if I can build it. I am 3 short. Okay. Is there stuff over here? I don't have whiskey. And I can't drink alcohol right now. I do have an umbrella hat. That's absolutely true. 100% true. Yeah, so, oh yeah, you guys are probably waiting for your bi-weekly Fallout 4 mods update for PS4. Yeah, okay, so talk to Todd once again. Todd said, man, they're just grinding away, you know? Trying to get those PS4 mods out. They're really just, it's kind of difficult, you know, to work with another company. You know, they have different deadlines, you know, different priorities, different company culture, so when you're having a collaboration like that between Sony and Bethesda, sometimes, you know, wires get crossed and you're not all on the same page in terms of timing. And so that's pretty much what Todd told me. So I've already been here, obviously. Oh, it's just like this one section. It's really laggy. Yeah, see, I mean, Fallout in London would be cool. I don't see them abandoning the U.S. as a backdrop, as a setting. Through the other tunnel, there's more uranium. Okay, we'll go over there then. Might as well scrap all this shit. This is the tunnel I've already been through. All right, which tunnel are we talking about? I'm not a big fan of the Enclave. The Enclave are just kinda, they're a different kind of crazy. You know what I mean? Just a different kind of crazy. Everyone's a certain kind of crazy. Or a specific kind of crazy. This is... Oh, that's a Deathclaw. Hello. Yeah. Do I have anything to actually kill this? I mean... Come at me, bro. I do have these I could be throwing, too. So, dude. Alright. Pretty good little dodge there. Legendary Alpha Deathclaw. Need to make sure he runs into it. There we go. Alright. I actually might die here. Yeah, I don't deal nearly enough damage. I'm gonna get GG wrecked right now. And he's like body blocking the hell out of me. Yeah, I'm not a high enough level to deal with this. This is not happening. Guess I should quick save. Although it's not gonna help me. Nah, I can't do anything about this. I'm totally not worried about this. I'm remaining calm. I don't know what he was doing right there. Yeah, I'll let Clem deal with him. I successfully ran away, actually. Alright, so let's not go over there. I could go into workshop and build a wall. That would have worked maybe, right? I just want to go directly to the nuclear material. We're so close to nuclear material. I just want to build that generator. That's all I want. That's all I've ever wanted. This way, because I remember the place of nuclear material being here. This is it. I just went the wrong way. Yeah. Let's put on some Rad-X first. I'm really glad that bro decided to stop chasing me. Oh. Did I miss anything above me over here? No, I didn't. Yeah, let's go ahead and grab all this. I like that they put this down here. It's kind of cool. Excuse me. Nope, I would like this. Thank you. What do I want Bethesda to add in the next Fallout or TES? I don't know specifically. Jesus Christ! Backing up. I don't really need the rest of that uranium. Yeah, I could build some turrets to handle that Deathclaw, definitely. There's definitely ways to handle those situations. Alright. So I don't have the ceramic for the super reactor, but I don't think I'll need it. So I'm just gonna build this right here. Is that a new dweller? Welcome! Hello!
Just wanted to introduce myself.
What's up?
I wanted to personally thank you for giving us this opportunity. So, is there anything you need me to get started on?
Not right now.
Not right now. Thanks. All right, then.
Okay. Oh, God, it's off-centered. Well, it's going to be no matter what, because it occupies two spaces. Yeah, I'm gonna move it a little bit. Okay. So let's get some nice lighting up in here. Put some stuff on the roof. Go all the way over here to the new fancy lights. Looks nice and official. I don't think I'm gonna spend that much time trying to make sure these are all completely straight. Oh god. Oh god, this is already, it's already triggering me. Okay. Let's do rotate that way. There we go. Okay. Close enough. I already got that one, yeah. Oh god, that one's at such a bad angle. That's all right. Oh man. It's a real strug. Strug is real. Let's do that. Wow. We have maintained a really high amount of viewers. Thank you guys. It's really awesome. I can't tell you the last time I've had 500 viewers basically watching for an extended period of time. So in theory, the way this connected power works is that everything's connected, right? And so all I need is a power conduit, which I don't have enough materials for. Oh shit, this is not gonna work. So this is only gonna fit, oh wait. What if I put a wall here? Atrium wall. Oh, that deserves a ban. Let's not do that. Block. There we go. Alright. Oh my god, John Favreau strikes again. Okay, let's go back to power, connectors and switches, and put on our nice power conduit. Why is that not connecting? Why does it want to connect on this wall, but not this wall? That is absolutely mind-boggling to me. Oh my goodness. Well, this is what I thought would work. Sometimes when you put on no collision, it messes things up. So I'm gonna take that off and build some supports. Like we're actually constructing something here. Are you serious? Is that really? Okay. Some really spooky, scary music going on. Screw it. I just want to get up there, man. That's all I want. We're going to get up there. It's going to be sloppy, but we're getting up there. Yeah, I should have used the scaffolding. I got up there. That's what I wanted. All right. Go back over to power. And it's still not going to work. We're definitely going God mode for this. Because I don't want to keep building those these power conduits. So there's a certain distance that the conduit needs to be to the thing you're trying to power, but it's like, how are you supposed to put some nice lighting up there? It's like you can't. Yeah, we're on PC right now, guys. Like, this is great lighting. Like, this is exactly what I want. Just doesn't seem like we're gonna be able to do it, I guess. How about I try this? Let's try one more thing, and then I'm gonna abandon the lighting on the top. I can run power lines. So like this, and then if I want to make things as clean as possible, and then okay. So I could just run these along the top. That's okay. So I could run one of these every few. Aha! So this answers your question. Yeah, I could place the wires outside of the top, but honestly, I'm just kind of experimenting right now. This isn't like the end all be all final build of this vault. Shit. Run that over to you. Ah. I need to build some supports to get higher. How about I just try to, make life a lot easier. Yeah. Okay. Up there. Yeah, this music is obnoxious, is it not? Hey-oh. Okay. Is it because of the no collision? Doesn't even seem like it's acknowledging that that's a power conduit. Yeah, sometimes stuff just doesn't work when you're using no clip. How about I build this floor out a little bit? I think I was gonna do that anyways. The floor slash ceiling. Ceiling and floor. I don't need to be floating right now. Like so. And then, oh well, we can't put the... I'll just make a series of stairs. Placing this stuff for right now. Yeah, so if you're not familiar with PC and console commands, TCL is the little console command for no collision that allows you to fly and just clip through stuff, like go straight through walls. And then TGM is God mode. Gives you unlimited resources and like pretty much unlimited action points. And you don't die, really. I said I was going to make stairs, didn't I? Alright, let's do that. Some stairs. Alright. Still not letting me do what I want to do. It is really obnoxious. How about I turn that off? Or down. It's ridiculous. It really is obnoxious. Yeah, it's the Deathclaw. All right. Is this, are the supports gonna work on top? Okay, they actually are working on top. Grab this other one. Oh, but something needs to go underneath it. Let's get rid of these supports. All right. Hop up top here. No, excuse me, thank you. All right. Go under vault once again. All right. Beautiful, beautiful. And this is gonna get us where we need to be. Yes. And that lights the rest of it. That's basically all I wanted to do. That was a lot of effort just for that. Okay. All right, so yeah, not the prettiest thing I could have done along the top, like someone said, but just didn't. I guess I could have put that stuff on the outside. Yeah, so if I were to do this, you know, again, I would repeat that same process over on this side. And if I could actually close this side, I would do that too. And also I would lead to kind of other places from the central area. But I kind of like this concept of this giant big atrium room. I think it's really cool. All right. Do you have to use the domestic structures to build rooms for settlers? I'm not sure about that. A lot of my experimentation with this so far has been just for the two videos I've made so far and what you guys have seen right now. The lighting is still not good though. Like it's too high up. It would need to be I would need to have lots of lights like along here, like for example, let's do just a little bit more. I think there's some nice wall mounted lights. Subway light. That's not really what I meant. Yeah, these are ceiling lights. Oh, fluorescent wall light. Kind of like that, yeah. But I mean, as you can tell, this connected power just lets you put it everywhere. And if I just put this everywhere, I mean, the place is lit AF, right? I only say that ironically. Don't freak out. so that's not receiving the power. If we put a... Am I in the right place? No, no, I'm not. So much scrolling. There we go. There, all that is lit. I'm just going to finish this out, and then we're probably going to end the stream, guys. We have passed our two-hour mark, and we did complete what we came here to do, which was finish the Vault 88 stuff. And then we got a pretty decent build out of this. I'm pretty happy with what we have. Obviously, I would be a lot more careful if I, you know, actually looks pretty cool. I'd be a lot more careful if I were, like, actually trying to build something really, really cool. But yeah, I hope you guys got something out of the fact that you can put some nice lights up in atriums and whatnot. You can light it up. Captain Amazing, unfortunately, we're about to wrap things up. But this entire stream, if you want to watch it, which we completed Vault 88's entire quest line and then built this little vault structure here, will be uploaded on my channel a little bit later today. But anyways, guys, I'm going to go ahead and wrap it up. I'm going to prepare another video today. At least that's the plan for tomorrow, because I'm going to be moving all day tomorrow into my new apartment. And so I'll share that with you guys in my next little vlog update video, which should be this weekend on a Sunday. But anyways, guys, thank you for joining me today. We had a lot of viewers. I really appreciate it. Thank you, Madara. I did have a lot of fun on this stream with you guys, and I hope you enjoyed yourselves as well. So again, normal video schedule pretty much. Should expect something tomorrow, DLC related. Could just be about experiments. I don't know though, because like experiments you can't really do that much stuff with. They're not really as compelling as I would have hoped they would have been. Perhaps a review of the DLC. Maybe that makes the most sense. But anyways, guys, once again, hope you enjoyed this stream, and I will talk to you all next time. I'll be streaming probably this coming Saturday if all goes to plan. So anyways, talk to you guys next time. Peace.